In 2017, DAF carried out a complete overhaul of the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system in the CF and XF. Today, we're going to take a look at the operation of this system to help you keep comfortable and get the very best out of your DAF. The heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system is all controlled through this control panel. There are two main configurable variants available: automatic temperature control and cabin climate control. The latter can be identified by the automatic function button, which controls the temperature, blower, and air distribution. Both variants can be specified with or without a rest heat function, and with or without an auxiliary heater, more commonly known as a night heater. This rest heat function is the system we're going to look at now. During periods of rest, it can be tempting to leave the engine idling, but with this system, there is a superb eco feature known as the rest heat function. When the engine is switched off, rest appears on the controller, and pressing the soft key will give you 30 to 45 minutes of residual heat from the engine, allowing the cab temperature to be maintained until the coolant temperature drops. Let's look at how this works. A separate coolant pump circulates the hot coolant from the engine into the heater matrix, where the warm air is distributed through the normal cab ventilation ducts. You can increase the blower speed, adjust the temperature, or simply engage the automatic function on the cab climate control option to maintain a comfortable temperature. The rest heat can last for up to 45 minutes, depending on ambient conditions, until the engine coolant temperature drops. Now let's take a look at the auxiliary or night heater, which is optionally available. For rest periods longer than 45 minutes, or when the engine is cold, you will need to engage the auxiliary heater to warm the cab. This is done by simply pressing P. This will initially use any residual heat in the coolant before engaging a separate diesel-powered heater to maintain the temperature of the coolant in the heater matrix, bypassing the engine. Again, the warm air is distributed through the existing cab ventilation ducts. The auxiliary heater is also available with a timer function, so you can ensure the cab is warm and comfortable when you start your shift. Full instructions on how to set the timer are contained in a separate video, which we have linked below. It's important to note that if the ignition is switched on for any reason, the auxiliary heater will disengage. At all times, whether driving, using the rest function, or when using the auxiliary heater function, the cab temperature can be manually adjusted or set to auto using the control panel. Thank you for watching.